हेलो स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू दी ऑनलाइन लेक्चर्स ऑफ डिज़ाइन ऑफ आरसीसी एंड स्टील स्ट्रक्चरल एलिमेंट्स थ्रू जेसीई कनेक्ट। सो इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैड अ डिस्कशन ओवर द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ शेयर फोर्स एंड बेन्यूमेंट and we had a discussion over the shear force distribution and movement, the bending moment distribution in the combined footing due to the upward soil pressure. Okay, then later we got to know that the actual behavior of the combined footing. Okay, so we got the shear behavior of the combined footing and also the bending behavior of the combined footing. Okay, and so this is the location where the shear force is zero. Okay, and as you know that where the shear force is zero, at that particular location bending moment will be maximum, correct na? At the location of zero shear force we have to find out, or the location of maximum bending moment will be there. Okay, so by that we have calculated the location of maximum bending moment also. Okay, as I told you in the as I discussed, so we here we have, by using the similar triangle method, we have calculated. So we got that at a distance x, so this is distance x from column A. So this is the column A, this is the axis for column A, and this is axis for column B, and we got that the location of maximum bending moment. So here I can, if I project this here, if I project here, okay, this is the point of maximum bending moment. Okay, at a distance x from column A, that is 1.56, at a distance of 1.56 we'll get maximum bending moment, or x bar is nothing but what, it's from the left end of the footing, that is point C, that is the left end of the footing, that is point C, nothing but x bar. So this is x bar, so we got that value as 2.08. so either it is 1.56 meter from column A or 2.08 from the left end of the footing, that is point C, we got the maximum, the location of maximum bending moment, that is 2.08. so let us calculate the value of maximum bending moment also. Okay, the value of maximum bending moment also. Okay, so we'll calculate that. So now the maximum bending moment, that is, I can write bending moment bracket max is 180 into 2.08 square minus 750 into 2.08, sorry, it is not 2.08, it should be 1.56 okay, understood? So it is 180 into 2.08 square, so minus 750 into 1.56. so I can show you here. Okay, here I can show it here. Okay, so yahan pe here it is in the loading diagram. I can show you. Okay, so here it is. Okay, so it is at a location of, you have got already. So somewhere here you have got. Okay, so this we have got it as 2.08, correct? This value, so we have got it as 2.08 from left end, that is C. So kya hoga abhi? 180 into 2.08 square, 180 into 2.08 square minus 750 into 0.56. Let us, I'll show it better there only. Okay, so I can redraw the sketch here and show you once again. Okay, so here we have got this. Okay, I'll show you. Okay, so here, so this is column A, load acting column A, that is 1.5 into 500. Okay, and we have the upward pressure. We have the upward pressure. Okay, so that is 360 kilonewton per meter. Okay, and this distance I'll consider here, from here to here it is 2.08, location of, so this will be continued, I'll just, okay, and this distance is 0.56, correct, to here, up to, for at the location of maximum minimum. Okay, so I'll just redraw this here, I'll rewrite here. So what will happen here, this will be 360, so W into L square by 2, so that is 360 into 2.08 into 2.08 by 2, W into L into L by 2, because it's a UDL, W into L into L by 2, so this will be nothing but 180, so if I make it this, this will become 180 into 2.08 square, so this will same, 180 into 2.08 square, minus the load is 750, okay, acting in this direction, so 750 into 1.56. Okay, so this is, I think, 1.56, okay, 1.56, okay, 750 into 1.56, so we'll check here, so we got 360, I'll just check, 360 into 2.08 square minus 750 into 1.56, okay, so we'll get this value as 1.56, okay. This value will get it as 391.24 kilonewton meter. Understood? So this is the bending moment maximum. So we got the maximum moment as 391.24. I can show it that in the bending moment distribution. Okay, here I can show it. This we got as 391.24. Okay, we have got this as 48.67 under column A. Under column B, we got 209.85, and at the mid, okay, between A and B, we got the maximum minimum is 391.24 kilonewton meter. Understood? So we have got bending moment under column A, under column B, even we got the maximum bending moment between A and B. Okay, then next we have to find out the location of point of contraflexure. Okay, the location of point of contraflexure. So in the last session, I made one correction there. This I called as the point of contraflexure. So this is not a point of contraflexure, this is the location of maximum bending moment. Okay, now we have to find out the location of point of contraflexure, means where the bending moment changes its sign. from positive to negative. So this we have to find out, the point of contrast ligature here and here, these two locations we have to find out. So let us find out that. Okay, now the point of contrast ligature okay, by making it bending moment is equal to zero, and we'll consider, so we'll consider at a distance x, so this we have again 750, and bottom we have the upward load, so this is the x we'll consider, this is 360 kilonewton per meter, okay, and we'll take bending moment at xx is equal to 0, bending moment at x is equal to 0, okay, then, so if I write this, we'll get this value is, I'll consider x, this distance I'll consider x, so here it will be, so therefore it will be 360 into x square by 2, because UDL, so 360 into x square by 2 minus 750 into x minus 750 into x minus 0.52, 0.52, because this distance is 0.52, okay, so understood, 360 into x square by 2 minus 750 into x minus 0.52, okay, so this we will get it as, when you solve this we will get it as 180, so this will be equal to 0, 180 into x square minus 750 into x minus, sorry, plus 390 is equal to 0. Understood? We got this as 180 x square minus 750 x plus 390 equal to 0. So now what you have to do? You have to use this equation and you have to insert in your calculator. So that time you will get two values, that is x is equal to 3.56 meter and one more value x is equal to 0.609 meter. We will get two values. Okay. When you insert these values, okay, this is in terms of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Okay. So by this, you will get two values of x. X is equal to 3.56, x is equal to 0.609. So what does it indicate? Two values, I'll just show it here. So because our, it is like both side overhang, like in the Bellman diagram, we have two points, that is location of contrast ligature. So means, it means, okay, we have here, this value is from left end C, this value is 0.609, and one more value, this value as from here to here, it is 3.56. It is 3.56 because we have two points of contrast ligature. So from the left end C we got 0.609, that is first point contraflexure, and again the left end C we got the second point, that is at a distance of 3.56 meter. Understood why we have got two values? Okay, then next is you have to go for the calculation of or the depth of footing. Depth of footing. Next is depth of footing. Depth of footing. Okay, so for that, by equating mu is equal to mu limit. You have to equate mu is equal to mu limit. By equating mu is equal to mu limit. So mu is equal to the value of mu limit. Okay, based on the grade of steel, it is Fe415, so that is 0.138 fck bd square. It is based on again the grade of steel. Mu is equal to 0.138 fck bd square. So we have got the mu, the maximum mu, that is 391.25 into 10 to 6, then 0.138 fck is 20, and b we have to use as 2000, and d we have to find out. B, the width of the footing is 2000, and d we have to find out. So by doing this we will get d is equal to, you have to send it here and you have to get the square root of d. So we will get it at d is equal to 266.23 mm. We will get it d as 266.23 mm. Okay, so this, the depth of the footing, whatever we have got, this is for bending moment consideration. For bending moment consideration. But one more factor we have to consider here for depth, which is very important. For depth, not only bending moment, but one more important factor we have to consider, that is shear. What? Shear. Because what will happen? To resist the bending moment, we provide the reinforcement in the footing. To resist bending moment, we provide steel. In any case, it may be bending in the beam, bending in the slab, or bending in the column. Correct. To resist bending, because bending means nothing but tension. So the concrete is not strong in tension. To make it resistance, we provide reinforcement in concrete additional. Okay. So here also, in same case, to resist bending moment, we can provide reinforcement, that is steel. But the one more important factor, that is shear. Shear can be resisted only and only through concrete. That is based on the shear capacity of concrete. Correct. So shear can be resisted by concrete. So what will happen? If you provide the same depth of footing, whatever we got with respect to bending moment consideration, because this depth, whatever you have calculated, that is with respect to bending moment consideration, not shear consideration. So what you have to do here, for factor of safety or for shear consideration, increase this depth of footing, increase this depth of footing 2 to 2.5 times. Okay, 2 to 2.5 times. So I can write here. So here, for shear consideration, shear consideration, increase the depth for shear consideration, increase the depth d by, you can increase the depth by 2 to 2.5 times. Increase the depth by 2 to 2.5 times. So I'll increase by 2 times. So therefore, D is 266.23 into 2. So we'll get this value as 532.46 mm. So I'll let us round figure. So I'll consider as 540 mm. I'll consider D is equal to 540 mm. And assuming a effective cover is equal to 60 mm, because clear cover is 50 mm for generally for footing, clear cover will be 50 mm. And assuming diameter of 20 mm, so it will be 50 plus dia by 2, so it will be 50 plus dia by 2 here, assuming effective cover of 60 mm. Okay, so therefore the capital D will be 540 plus effective cover 60 mm, so we'll get this D as 600 mm. Okay, the depth of footing will be, the total depth of footing will be 600 mm. Okay, or overall depth, the total depth or overall depth will be 600 mm, and the effective depth will be 540 mm. This is regarding the calculation of depth of footing. Then next we have to go for area of reinforcement. So to go for area of reinforcement, understood? Okay, so now for bending moment, for area of reinforcement, okay, we have the combined footing loaded with column A and column B. So this is column A and column B, okay. And with respect to this, we have the upward pressure here. And here, the behavior of the footing when this slab subjected to a two point loads A and B, and even the upward pressure from the downward side. This is the upward pressure from downward side. So because of that, the bending behavior of the beam or a footing, it will be, so when this part try to push down, this column try to push down and this pressure try to push up, so the behavior, it will be like, so here this part will go up because this is pushing down and this is pushing up, so this part will be, so it will bend like this. I try to, okay, this part will bend like this, and when it is pushing down, and this will also try to push, so this part will come like this. It will be like this. Can you imagine? Okay, this part will go up like this, this part will go up like this. So it's a behavior. So this is 1 and this is 2, both are. So you can see two types of behavior here. Okay, so what will happen here? Why it is two types of behavior? So because this is bending upward, so we can have the tension at the upward face, the top side, the top of the footing, because it is the behavior of the bending, the pattern is like this, so the tension will be at top. But here, what will happen here? So it will act as a cantilever portion, so here the tension will be at bottom. Understood? So here the main reinforcement in this location we have to provide at the bottom, here or here. Are you getting my point? But here it is bending like this, so tension will be here, so we have to provide the reinforcement here. That is a change in the behavior. Okay. One and two. So therefore, I can write here, therefore the positive bending moment, what you have got in bending moment diagram, positive bending moment, that is sagging, that is reinforcement at top, sorry, reinforcement at bottom, and the negative bending moment, that is hogging, that is reinforcement at top, we have to provide. Okay, what you have got in this thing, the in bending moment, to provide at top. So in the next session we'll go for the calculation of reinforcement, that is calculation of area of reinforcement under column A, under column B, and at midspan. Okay, so if you have any queries regarding today's session, you can contact me. Okay, thank you.